Hello everyone. Today we'll be mucking about with common name flat-bodied mayflies, family Heptageniidae, and there are numerous genera in this family and over 500 species. More notable that most have probably heard about are this Stenonema and the Epiorus. My hook, standard nymph hook. Tails or moose mane. Got three of them. Most have of this family have three tails. I believe the Epiorus only has two. A lot of people ask impressionistic versus realistic or semi-realistic, fishable realistic, whatever you want to call them. Impressionistics are like the pheasant tail hare's ear, where they're imitating multitude of insects. Whereas your fishable realistics, you're isolating or picking out key morphological features like tails, gills, eyes, legs, and you're imitating more of a, I guess, a specific species or family. So next, some raffia or Swiss straw. This marks up very well. I have a chunk about 5 millimeters or so. And I cut a 2-point. Prepared it, but 15-pound chameleon maxima, and took a pair of tweezers and a lighter. You want those eyes about maybe 4 millimeter across. I saw this technique years back by Ollie Edwards. You can do lead. This is copper wire. This particular hook size, I use a small. And as the name implies, flat body mayflies. Very, very flat. Allows them to cling to the rocks better. Low pro, very robust insects, most of them. So we're going to crisscross that wire and create this diamond shape. Pretty cool technique, if I say so. Take your flat-nosed pliers and flatten that out. Next, we'll do the gills. What I did, ostrich. And I stripped one side. And then this would be the tip side. And then the butt side here. I go about halfway down the feather. Usually don't use the tip because they are very fragile. So I go about halfway down the feather. Do that twice. And this one I strip the other side. So when we fold it, the gills will be on the side See, so they're the fibers or the barbs are pointing inward on each one. And next we'll do some pheno skin. Or Flexibody. I like to do like a lighter color and then mark it with a marker. And that way you'll actually get a two-tone finished product where the body will be lighter on the belly and then darker on the back. So I want to take this and cut it to a point. I used to play music, but I had a user tell me to speak faster, which I'm 55 years old, so I talk slow, always have, and turn the damn music off. So I turn the music off, but I can't speak faster. Incidentally, that pheno skin is like a flat sheet, and you use a straight edge and a razor blade and trim it to your size. That one was about maybe a millimeter and a half. I thought I was all prepared, muffed something up. So for more durability, I will put some resin on here. But I usually put mono thread to rib it, to give it more to give that ostrich more durability. But as I said, I muffed up. I forgot to put it in there. Tried to be all prepared and everything, and got sidetracked. And then these are a little long. Careful, don't cut your tails. Got one stray one there. The fish don't care if you get them all perfect, but I like them perfect. Or somewhat perfect, I should say. Okay, so now I took a neck feather from a mega quail. So I don't think you can get these anymore, but you could use English partridge. And I prepped that feather with some flexible adhesive to make it teardrop shape. That'll be, again, that's the wing case. Now for the legs, you can do it numerous ways. Some people use guinea. This is golden pheasant. And what I do so if you have your feather concave facing up, when I don't have a lot of room to get closer, but I'll isolate a barb and pluck it and go to the other side, isolate a barb and pluck it, and the one I just plucked is for this side of the bug, and the first one I plucked is for this side, the side away from you. And you can see when you pluck it, it almost gives the illusion of like a, what would be a claw. So we'll do that two more times. As far as the legs are concerned, incidentally, these tweezers are your friend. just a little longer. Okay. I'm gonna take a little bit of squirrel fly tying store. I'm not sure where that is. I think it's Austria maybe. I have all sorts of materials from all over. And this is like a golden stone or golden yellow. And yes, I've cut my leg before. After all that. And some would say, it's all for show, blah, blah. But I like tying them. And they catch fish, especially on a tough day. Where the fish are being finicky. Last set of legs here. Using the guinea, what you can do is I think I have a, at least how I've seen it done. I've tried it. I didn't particularly like it, the end result. But you can take 6 each side. And then tie that in, and then obviously shorten them, and then you can bend with a lighter and a tweezer. You can bend your legs, sets of 2, to create 3 legs on each side with the 6 fibers. Take a little bit of resin.